Praja ng Monsignor, mga kabugtuan ko nga kapadian ng Diakono, our honorable government officials, headed by the city mayor of Calvayo, Honorable Mayor Ronald Aquino, together with his vice mayor, Honorable Jinjin Puri, and the city councilors of the city of Calvayo. And I think here with us this morning also is the congressman of the 1st District, Honorable Congressman Mel Sinel Sarmiento. And I do not know if she is here, nasiring mo siya sa akong lumakali siya yun na, the provincial governor of the province of Western Samar, Honorable Governor Shari Ann Tang, together with some of the board members, Hermanas Mayores 2011, nga mahiray Thilma Diomamay Manamot, Delia Corrales Diomamay, Tomasa Corsiga Antivo, and Sheila Soseng Montago, Hermanas Pasadas Inluminadas, mga kabugtuan ko nga mga balikbayan, mga bisita, mga ikasidibuto ko sa mahal nga Birhen Maria, mga kabugtuan ko na ni Kristo, mamurayaw ng malipayon nga patron, paiyo nga tanan. Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. Adi na liwat kita, nagkakatiyo pagsalimburog sa natong kapistahan, Pahinungod, sa natong patrona, Our Lady of or Our Lady's Nativity. Sa akong wali yan na, mamalandong kita sa mga pagbasa nga ato lang nababi. Ang atot siya man na pagbasa, yan na, tikang san basahon, san gingpadayag, o Book of Revelation, nga na atot santos nga Ebanghelyo naman, ay tikang san Ebanghelyo nga sinulat ni San Lucas. Ang atot siya man na pagbasa, nagsumat itong mahitungod sin babae nga ngan ang dragon. Ang pagbasa na sirin aray po usap na babae nga nababaduan san adlaw na tamak san bulan nga ng iya ulo na pupudung-pudungan sindusi ng mga bituon. Di pag-aranak na siya nga ginulingat siya tunod han ulul sa iya pagbati. Katapos ginadubang san dragon ang tipag-aralak na babae, basi lamunon ang bata kung manganak na siya. Angkot. Ang apaliwat na santos ng Ebanghelyo, nagsumat itong mahitungod sa pagsiring sa anghel kang Maria, na siring ang anghel, aday po, kita nagpapanangkot ang imot tiyan ngan mag-anak kasing anak na lalaki ngan pagnangaralan mo hiya si Jesus. Unquote. Mga kabugtuan, ang babae naging hihinabi dida sa basahan sa gingpadayag, amo ini si Maria naging iginhinabi dida sa santos na Ebanghelyo, ang dragon naman amuhi Satanas. In other words, si Satanas nag-atake sin babae si Maria nga nagbata didak sa iya tiyan. Ang bata nga adak sa iya tiyan naging aatake ni Satanas wala iba kundi si Jesus. Si Jesus nga adak sa tiyan ni Maria nagrepresentar iton sa mga kabataan nga dili panatawo, the target of Satan's attack through abortion. Brothers and sisters, the works of Satan symbolized by the dragon are obviously works of hatred, killing, and the destruction of human life. The desire of Herod to kill the newborn king, na nakita niya na threat to his kingdom, was motivated by Satan, the dragon who wanted to kill the Savior of the world. Mga kabuntuan, duwa ka tuig ang naglabay, ang usap ka popular na hiswita na pali, na aliwa Pilipinas, tuktub yan ang alipa, in Father James Luther, Nasirin, and I quote, "There is a spiritual battle going on in our country right now," and I unquote. Yes, the spiritual battle is on, and this spiritual warfare is great, terribly great. It is a battle between God and Satan. It is a battle between good and evil, between Mary, the woman of Revelation, chapter 12, and the dragon, namely Satan. Satan attacks the woman and the child in her womb. Mga kabuntuan ko, nilagkan Kristo ng mahal nga Birhen Maria. Ang atong mga pagbasa iyan na reminds me san usap ka mapasok ma-issue iyan na nga amo ang reproductive health bill or RHB 4244. He Father Yolito Ignacio STL Karuyag Sidmon Padi nga maya licensure san Sacred Theology Nasirin, and I quote, "Having studied Mariology in Rome and having understood myself the exegesis of the book of Revelation chapter 12 on the woman and the dragon and relating it to the proposed RX bill, I can clearly say that the proposed House bill on reproductive health is in reality a subtle and satanic attack against family life and the lives of the unborn babies," unquote. Kung tanawon lang natin ang RH, sumalat sa ginsurat, ginsurat lang sa papel, maupay hinduro. Pero in reality, damo gid ang mga double meanings na awang gintatago. Ang proposed House Bill on Reproductive Health nag-promote san value-free sex education for children ng mga binata that encourage them to be promiscuous. Ang target nila among mga bata ng patanon. Kaya ano? Kaya tumong amuman ang paghigo sa mga patanon na sexually active. Kaya ano? Tungod kay ang mga batanon represent a huge market for family planning activities such as selling of contraceptives, sugars and condoms, and pills. Ang sex education itutu sa mga publiko at privado na eskwelahan o dungin modify na ito instead in grade 4, minimum grade 6, tutu high school, but even then, sex education pa rin. As it is written right now, tikan sa grade 4, tuktub sa 4th year high school. Unong katuig na pag-aram has sex. Mas halapag pa kaysa pag-aram sa talis degree, sugat siton magmaistra ng iba pa. Pagkatima, hanunong katuig na mag-aram has sex, ang iyong anak, may nalagin tatawag na doctor in sexology. This value-free sex education is actually a violation of parent rights. to educating the children according to the spiritual and religious values. Ang proposed House Bill, mada itong tinawag na punitive aspect. Karuyang signal na kung may, kung ma-approve na itong, sino nga ang magiyakan kontra si doon, piprisuhon nga may multa pa. Ano na si Cardinal Vidal San Cebu Santo ng Cardinal Rosales sa Manila na sirin, and I quote, "We are willing to be put to jail for the sake of Christ and the gospel values," unquote. He Professor Sherla Najera, professor sa University of the Philippines na sirin, and again, I quote, "The reproductive health is all about reproductive rights." Ano ka-exit nun? Ka-exit nun na ang reproductive health originally nagtikang ito noon pa ang termino nga reproductive rights, a phrase designed by some women of the International Conference of Women in Beijing in September 1995 and defined as the right of women over their reproductive system. Anong kareaksin mo? In the name of women's right, the women are free to do whatever they want to do with their body. If I may exaggerate it, they are free to do sex with anybody, anywhere, anytime, as long as, according to the Department of Health, they use the essential medicines. Ano itong essential medicines na tinatawag nila? No other than contraceptives, pills, and all of the other contraceptives that you know. And it's just in case using your right and you're free to do sex with anybody, anytime, and anywhere, you will get pregnant, which they used to call unwanted, then you are free, in the name of women's rights, you are free to go to an abortionist and have it aborted. That is what we mean by reproductive rights. Mga kabugtuan, ang problema natin yan, as we know very well, dili overpopulation, kundi terrible corruption. Poverty is an economic problem. Poverty needs an economic solution and not the demographic solution that population control pretends to give. Paano maging tama ang mali kung ang solusyon ay mali, sabi ng isang demographer? Sabi ng mga tao, walang mahirap pag walang corrupt, but RX bill is moral corruption. The battle is going on in our country. And the battle is a battle between gospel values and money. Why money? Because RX involves millions of dollars as incentives and monetary compensation to destroy life for those who support it. The battle is on. And the battle is between generosity and greediness, common good and personal interests. The battle is between spiritual wealth and worldly riches. It is a battle between the kingdom of God and the kingdom of the evil one. Brothers and sisters, we must not be afraid to cry out our faith and stand for our faith in Jesus and proclaim our faith in Him and His gospel values. The gospel na sirin ang angel Gabriel to Mama Mary. Mary, do not be afraid. Yes, do not be afraid. Let's cry out our faith and stand for our faith, even if it would mean dying. Pipisuhon ko na naman. We must look at Mary and ask Mary to strengthen us. Mary is the mother of life because she brought forth Christ, the light of the world. Satan is the prince of darkness. The world, brothers and sisters, is full of darkness. Mary is full of grace. Mary is filled with the Holy Spirit. Mary will be our defense against the attacks of the evil spirits. Ha iyong matangan, once again, mamurayaw ngan balipayon na patuloy.